half an hour.
Okay. I know in the USA when you work extra half an hour, you get paid. You get overtime. But here we are losing time. Okay, so we'd like everybody to be on time. Before we start, I'd like to do a short prayer, or maybe we'll pick a volunteer to just give us a short prayer. And Gloria, would you like to lead us in a short prayer? Okay. How about...
Two are very great souls. First of all, one of my good friends, who is a devotee and still a devotee of Swami Shivananda at the age of 9, and he was initiated in Rishikesh. My guru also, he was initiated at the same Divine Life Society in Rishikesh. And I found him on Facebook and we became friends, and so he's joining us today. So I'd like to welcome you, my good friend.
Madam, can you just take a video?
Did you start now? He just asked me for it.
Acha.
This is Naneshwar from Solapur. Beez. Bharat Bhushan. We are friends since 2 years. Last year we wanted to meet, but it got missed. And this year we met them. So it's a pleasure to be with you all. Let us all enjoy this day. Thank you so much. Thank you for giving me an opportunity and to be my divine brother. My divine brother.
Yeah,
thank
yeah.
you so much. Thank you. Okay,
thank you,
madam.
Our greatest tour guide, she lives in Mumbai and well known, and she used to be an agent for Bollywood actor Vinod Khanna.
Wow, so nice.
Friends, I'd like to introduce to you Cynthia Bharti, and she will tell you all about today. Bharti, not Bharti, Bharti. Okay.
Mumbai. And happy Holi to everyone. Okay. It's a colorful day and color festival. Everyone who has brushes or anything, just forget it. And let's be happy and enjoy the Holi. And we are all friends and blessed with love and joyful. And I also bless Bharatji and his family. They have given me this opportunity every year. He remembers me and gives that respect to me. I'm really thankful to Bharatji. He treats me like his sister. I'm one of his family members. So that respect he gives me every year, and he always wants me to be here. If anything, you guys have any suggestions for me at the end to improve my tour better, so please be free and tell me, okay, where I'm going wrong and where I'm going good. So you can give me the suggestions. Next year I'll be celibate everywhere. Okay? So let's start the tour.
My son, my two daughters are 22. Guess how old I am?
16.
Any guesses? I'm 52.
Wow. Like
yes, I'm 52 years old.
How old?
52.
52, 52. Half a century plus.
Next year, more young, I'll be like sweet 17. Next year, when you 16. See me. 16 or 17, maybe. Yes. Okay. Now, coming back to Mumbai. You must be wondering why every time I tell you the same story, some are new year, so I have to repeat this again. Now, why Mumbai? You must be thinking, why Mumbai? Why not Bombay? Before Bombay, it was called Mumbai Devi. You know Mumbai Devi. There's a temple also at Crawford Market, Mumbai Devi Temple. Yes. So that was the name given by the Marathis. And the Marathi is the language which we speak in Mumbai. Okay? Now, Maharashtra is our state. So we speak Marathi. Every state has different languages. Like Madras, it's now Chennai. So we speak Tamil. Bangalore, we say Bangalore now. The name has changed. And we speak Kannada. And Calcutta is now Kolkata. So we speak Bengali. So in Maharashtra, we speak Marathi. Marathi people are the rulers of Mumbai. Okay? Now, the king who gave independence for the Marathi people, you know what is his name? Anybody? He was the Maratha warrior. Any guesses? Any name? No. Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Yes. He was the Maratha warrior. He's the one who gave independence for us. Okay? So, they all are proud to say that my king Shivaji is our king and he's the one who gave independence for Mumbai people, Marathi people, and they're proud to say I'm G Mumbai. We say I'm G Mumbai, that means our Mumbai. Okay? Yes, I'm G Mumbai we say. And when the British came, for them it was very difficult to tackle with the Marathis. They can't understand what is Mumbai Devi and their language, their accent, their dialect, they cannot understand. At the same time, the Portuguese joined them. Yeah. In the Portuguese language, bomb means good and the sea, the bay, good bay. They connected together, Bombay. That's why it was called Bombay. The British ruled here for 200 years. 1947 we got independence, 1948 they all said bye bye to India and they all went back. After they went back, again in 1996, all the Marathi political leaders, they decided to change all the English name into Indian names. You know what Bombay became? Mumbai. And all the states' name got changed, like Bangalore became Bangalore, Calcutta became Kolkata, and Chennai, Madras became Chennai. So total states we have is 36 states. I can speak and read and write Hindi, Marathi, English, rest all the languages I can understand and I can speak. Now, this is all about Mumbai. Can you guess what is the population of Mumbai? Last time you came it was 24 million. This time is 25 million. No birth control. Yeah, now people are educated now. We are also going to the villages and trying to make them understand. Things are getting expensive now, so only one or two is enough. Still, some people need to understand that. They're telling it's God's given gift. You know, God gives us, so we can't stop it. But they don't understand that to earn money is so difficult and to give all the facility for the kids is nowadays, education is must. Without education you don't get anything, no jobs anywhere. So they should understand that. It's very difficult to survive in India, you know. Yeah, we have to struggle, work hard, then only you can give the necessity, whatever we want to give to our kids. So you need to understand that. Okay. This is all about Mumbai. Okay. Now coming back to the itineraries, what we are going to see today. Have you seen the movie The Slumdog Millionaire?
Yes.
Have you seen the laundry? In that movie?
Yeah.
The Dhobi Ghat? Yeah. You must be thinking Dhobi Ghat means it's a river and people washing clothes and work in the river. It's not a river. It's a place where they wash clothes and there is a facility of water, municipality, government, water, tap water. We have the electricity and people wash clothes there. 8,000 people work and they live there. And their job is to wash clothes. They are called the Dhobis. They are coming from a place in India called Uttar Pradesh, Bihari Babus. Okay. So they wash clothes, they're always happy and cheerful. They never cry or grip that this is a tough job for us. When we have laundry at home, we have the washing machine, we cry and we say, wow, so much clothes to wash today. But it's easy to wash in the machine, but these people wash with hands, no machines. Still they are happy and cheerful. Only they are working 24/7. They have shifts, morning, night, day, and early morning they start their day with happiness. You know, they never cry or grow so much clothes to wash. No. And they sing song, Bihari songs and all, and they wash clothes and so clean and tidy the clothes are. White clothes, you'll find that it's pure white. They put some bleach and chemicals. Clothes coming from the garment factories, all the colorful, same color clothes and like shirts, pants, you see denim clothes and all coming from garment. And hospitals, like the small hospitals, vast government hospital, 1-star, 2-star hotels, not the big hotels like West, Taj, Trident, Leela, they don't give the clothes. Reason is because after washing clothes, the dirty water is kept as it is. They don't have time to take that water immediately out. They are tired. After a week or 2 days, they take the water out. So this is the routine. They do it and they work very hard. They get paid 800 to 900 rupees per day, plus incentives, plus bonus, 2 salaries they get on the day of Diwali. Now, I'll just stop here because we'll see that bridge. You can see that long bridge. It takes us straight to South Mumbai now. We are in suburb and this is called North Mumbai. And you will find the auto rickshaws only in this area. But when you start crossing the bridge, you will not find any auto rickshaws. Because that's the business center. In the evening when you're coming back, that side at the left, you see when the tall buildings and the lights glitter in the evening, it's like New York City. It's so beautiful in the evening. We do have slums here, but slum means not poverty. People must be thinking slum, it's a miserable life, poverty life. No, that's their lifestyle. They have all the facility like us. They have mobile phones, they have auto rickshaws for business, they have Uber cars for business, Ola Uber. They have shops, grocery stores for business. Only the lifestyle is to live in the slum. They have also apartments, they give it on rent, but they don't want to go. They just live in the slum. They are happy living there. Yeah, it's not a miserable life. They don't want to pay lots of tax and rent and all. So slum is easy for them. They get electricity, they have the TV antenna you must be seeing everywhere. Now today is Holi, so you'll find lots of security everywhere, okay, every corner. Just for safer side. Nothing to get afraid, you need to enjoy the tour, okay. So people will talk rumors that don't go to India, don't go to Mumbai, Holi is coming, this is when, don't listen to them. Life is precious for us, I know, but we have to enjoy. So we need to think all positive, okay? If you go on thinking negative and be afraid, so nothing is going to be in your life. So be positive. Okay, so this is Bandra. Right side you'll find all the big buildings, you know, Taj Lansan. And behind Taj Lansan Hotel, we have Shah Rukh Khan, Salman Khan house. All Bollywood stars live here. I'm not telling you, if we finish with South, when we are coming back to North Mumbai, if we get time, I will pass through the Bollywood stars house. Okay? If we get time. So this is the toll which we are crossing now from here. Okay? So it will take us straight to South Mumbai. Now you will not find any auto rickshaws now. Stop. Yeah. Downtown will start now. This bridge is called Bandra Ceiling Bridge. It's called Rajiv Gandhi Bridge. Yes, yeah. This is hardly 6 years ago this bridge was built just to avoid traffic. Only 4-wheelers can pass through this bridge. Okay? No 2-wheelers, no 3-wheelers. And when we are passing through that, I will show you the richest man of India. You know who is he? Not Amitabh Bachchan. Is number 2 now. He was number 1. Mukesh Ambani. Ambani house, 27 floors, 600 servants. 122 cars with different models, two LE privates from the last year, the roof, and wedding members of his daughter and two sons. He is the owner of the phone company called Reliance, wedding was Geo, beyond change to Geo, and owner of IPL Foundation. Here in the hospitals, the wedding, reception was hotels, and it took 1 month for the wedding. He is the foreign delegate for Europeans every year, and no presents. He only gave the present, but present like the silver and golden, this Lakshmi and this Ganesh he gave. Gold and silver.
$2 billion.
Yes.
Geo.
Yes.
And Reliance.
Yes. Most expensive house.
Maybe.
Okay. And he gave a present last year.
One house.
Grand wedding of his daughter. And to Savena, one year, two or three weddings.
Now you see the fisherman's village here, right in front.
All these people are rich people.
Fishermen are very rich.
They are the rulers of Mumbai.
They are the wedding.
They are the
wedding.
Anyone.
And it took 1 month for the wedding.
All the foreign delegates. Popularity
of
popularity.
And no presents.
More than him.
They are fond of gold.
They earn money to give it. And golden.
They buy apartment bungalows and give it on rent.
And this is the warehouse where they they are very jolly and colorful and Reliance.
Yes.
See, this is all the warehouse.
They show the income tax.
This is our house.
And he gave
but
a present
on the
just a warehouse
with two floors.
It's huge.
Yes.
On the Vena Island.
This is the colorful house.
Now you see the fisherman's village here, right in front.
All these people are rich people. Fishermen are very
and when they come for fishing in the market, they
fish, they sell the fish,
they all dressed up.
Anyone?
They wear tons of gold.
If you touch them, when you finish the
same
fish which they cut in, that they take and they cut off
earn money to make
cut off your head and hands with the blade.
They buy apartments, bungalows and give it on rent.
And this is the warehouse where they show this.
They are very jolly and colorful.
If other people, Bihari
see, this is all the warehouse, and they show the income tax,
this is our house.
But this is not, this is just a warehouse.
Business.
Yes.
They are not allowed to sell.
This is the colorful house.
Right.
But real houses, the apartments all given by the
they if you are good to them, they are very good.
They and then they like for
fishing in the market, they fish, sell the fish, they all dressed up.
So much of gold.
No one has the guts to touch their gold.
If you touch them, then you
and
finish.
They're wearing the fish which they cut,
I had arranged
that they take in the cut of you.
The cut of your head and hands with the blade, yes.
Even the police is afraid of them.
Yes.
Because Mumbai is theirs.
Because they are doing
if other people, Bihari Babu sell fish, they just take the fish and they throw it out. How can you take our business? This is our business.
They're very jolly.
They're not allowed to sell.
Yeah.
Right.
We are in downtown.
This is the city begins. If you are good to them, they are very good.
This place is called Wari.
But if you are bad to them, fisherman's area.
Okay,
yes.
Now a little break. Anyone can sing? And then
their weddings, you should see
if
the
I go on talking about the tour, the people will get bored and they go to sleep.
I don't want people to sleep in my tour. Please wake up.
That 1 month before.
Holy Ekajanan Swami Ki Jai. Shiva Shankara Dina Dayala Mahavarada Aniyo Shiva Shankara Dina Dayala Mahavarada Aniyo Shiva Shankara Dina Dayala Mahavarada Shiva Shankara Dina Dayala Mahavarada
Once we go there, I'll explain to you, okay? So let's get down at Gobi Ghat now and see people washing clothes. Okay, now we are close to the Gobi Ghat. You can see from the left, all the clothes are hanging. And we'll be going there. We have a selfie point over there. Get down for 5 to 10 minutes or 15 minutes. And then we proceed, okay, to Hanging Garden.
Anybody want to do laundry?
Yes, Hanging Garden is for senior citizens, especially for senior citizens, but we are all young. Let's go there. And so why it's called Hanging Garden, once we go there, I'll explain to you, okay? So let's get down at Gobi Ghat now and see people washing clothes.
Thank you. some money. Some bags.
Anybody want to do laundry?
Anybody water stay for 2 weeks?
Or 2 weeks water.
2 weeks water.
No, my clothes.